Hello friends, welcome to Electronic Circuit Hub. So today we will understand the op-amp integrator. Okay, so the application of op-amp integrator is it is used in analog to digital converters and it is used in wave shaping circuits. Okay, so this is the circuit diagram of op-amp integrator circuit. Okay, this is the circuit diagram for practical op-amp integrator circuit. So here a capacitor is connected in the feedback loop, feedback path, and a resistor is connected at your input side. We will see the role of R2 and we will also see how a square wave can be converted into a triangular wave by taking an numerical examples. Okay. So before we understand the working of op-amp integrator, we'll see the capacitor charging behavior. Okay, so charge stored at capacitor Q equals to IC into T, where IC equals to charging current of this capacitor, and the charge stored Q equals to C into VC, where VC equals to voltage across this capacitor. Okay, this equation is in the form of current and this equation is in the form of voltage. If you apply a equivalence rule here, so ICT equals to CVC. Okay, so if you want to find VC, that is equals to VC equals to IC divided by C into T, and this is the equation for a straight line, which is equals to y equals to mx plus c. That means y equals to vc, m equals to ic divided by c, and c equals to 0. So now we have seen that voltage across the capacitor should develop linearly like straight line. Okay, so but it is not like that. Why? Because at time t equals to 0, the voltage across this capacitor is 0 volt. Okay, since it is 0 volt, it behaves like a short circuit. So your capacitor behaves like a short circuit. At that point of time, your charging current of this capacitor, that is IC equals to V in minus 0 divided by R. That means your IC equals to V in divided by R. So at t equals to 0, VC equals to 0, that this is VC equals to 0, and at that time your charging current is very high, that is IC is very high. Once your capacitor start charging with some current, okay, the voltage across this capacitor start developing. Okay, so let's say at some point of time, once your voltage across the capacitor reaches 2 volt, this is for example. So now if you want to calculate current again, that will be equals to V in minus 2 volt divided by R, which is quite less than your current at your time t equals to 0. So once the capacitor start charging, the voltage across capacitor start increasing. Okay, and some point of time your capacitor voltage reaches its maximum voltage of your input signal. At that point of time, your charging current decreases. Okay, and once your capacitor charge up to a maximum value, your charging current would be a very low. So this is the problem while using simple RC circuit. Now we will see how this problem can be rectified by using an operational amplifier. So this is your non-inverting terminal of an operational amplifier. So voltage across your non-inverting terminal is 0 volt. Voltage across your inverting terminal will be 0 volt due to virtual ground concept. So now if you want to find the input current, so I in equals to V in minus 0 divided by R1, which is equals to V in divide by R1. Okay, so you have to know that the voltage here is always, voltage at inverting terminal is always at 0 volt. Okay, so the voltage at your capacitor plus end is always 0 volt. So because of this, your capacitor will get a constant current to charge it. Okay, how? Since the input impedance of your operational amplifier is very high, so there is no current flow through the inverting terminal of an op amp. So at that time, your Iin equals to Ic. Okay, your Iin equals to Ic, which is equals to Vin divided by R1. Vin divided by R1. So at time t equals to 0, voltage across this capacitor is 0 volt. And once the current IC start flowing through it, capacitor start charging and it will charge linearly. Okay, so voltage across this capacitor is increasing linearly. Okay, so why it is increasing linearly? Since voltage at one terminal of your capacitor is always held at 0 volt. Okay, so because of your inverting terminal voltage is at 0 volt, so your charging current is fixed. That is why your capacitor charges linearly. So now we will see the output voltage of this operational amplifier, that is Vout. So whenever you apply a pulse input signal at op amp input terminal, okay, so since your capacitor charging rate is constant, which is equals to Vin divided by R1, that means your Vout decreases linearly until your op amp saturates at its maximum negative level. So Vout equals to minus V max. This is ideal condition. Okay, this is ideal condition for this op amp integrator. Now we will understand the working for your high side pulse and low side. So start from zero and reaches to maximum value, and then from maximum value it again reaches to 0 volt. Okay, so now if you want to find the rate of change of your output voltage, which is equals to delta V out divided by Vt, which is equals to minus Ic divided by C. Okay, this minus polarity marked with respect to polarity marked here, plus and minus, which is equals to Ic equals to Vin divided by R1. If you put here, you will get delta V out divided by delta T equals to V in divided by R1C. This is equation for the positive signal. Okay, for the negative signal you will have plus V in divided by R1C. Okay, now let us take an example and calculate the rate of change of output signal. Okay, so here your R1 equals to 10k and your capacitor C equals to 0.01 microfarad. So if you want to calculate the rate of change of output for positive signal, okay, that is at plus 2.5 volt, which is equals to minus Vin divided by R1C, which is equals to minus 5 volt divided by 10k into 0.01 microfarad, you will get minus 50 millivolt per microsecond. So your rate of change of your output signal when your input signal is high is equals to minus 50 millivolt per microsecond. If you want to calculate for the rate of change of output signal when your input signal is low, you will get plus 50 millivolt per microsecond. Now if you want to calculate the Vout, this Vout equals to, which is equals to delta V out into T, okay, so which is equals to 50 millivolt in per microsecond into 50 microsecond. So this time is, time period is 50 microsecond. We have already seen here this time period is 50 microsecond, right? So if you calculate this, you will get 2.5 volt. Okay, so your output is 2.5 volt. Okay, so minus 2.5 volt. So if for the positive signal, your output is varies from 2.0 to minus 2.5 volt, and for negative signal, your output varies minus 2.5 volt to 0 volt. You can see here for your positive signal, your output vary from 0 to minus 2.5 volt. For negative signal, your output varies from minus 2.5 to here 0 volt. Okay. So now let us discuss the role of this R2. This is basically used to improve the frequency response of an op-amp integrator circuit. And if you want to calculate the DC voltage gain, which is equals to minus R2 divided by R1, this R2 divided by R1, and AC voltage gain equals to minus R2 divided by R1 into 1 divided by 1 plus 2 pi f c into R2. And if you want to find the corner frequency, which is equals to 2 pi f c into R2. Okay. So thanks for watching this lecture. If you have any question, feel free to ask me in comment section.